And it wasn't, and it's not one of the guys where, look, you know how you have some guys who, you know, you sort of ID, okay, this guy's a little nutty, right, when it comes to that sort of stuff. This isn't one of those guys. I have not ID'd him as being nutty in any way at all. Very vanilla. Maybe even more vanilla than me. And I am straight up stone cold.
No, yeah, you're not even, there's no sweetener in you at all.
No, it's just like the straight stuff. It's not even delightful or good.
Concentrated.
That's right. It's like vanilla extract. That's
gentlemen, welcome to your two favorite facially blessed individuals. That's right, that's what I'm talking about. It's two bearded preachers aiming to misbehave on this wonderful, wonderful day. That's right, we are ready to go. We're gonna start at 11 and then we're gonna crank it up to 15 real fast. That's what we're gonna do.
Whoa.
Yeah, we're gonna amp it up real
from
11
fast. 11 to 15. Yeah. You are going to need to talk to a hearing specialist at the end of this episode. Is that what you're saying? Because we're going to talk about all the major events of the day.
And
everything.
And some stuff that nobody wants to even hear about.
That's right. And that's even after the stuff that that's us talking. Yeah. We had a conversation before we even started recording that would just make your ears blister. Yeah. It's unbelievable.
Couldn't record it because it was so unrecordable.
No. Unrecordable. Really primed us up for an excellent conversation this evening.
Got us amped, so. All right.
Okay.
There we go.
So you got it all out of your system then, is what you're telling me.
I what?
You've got it all out of your system then. All that
you
other
get it all out of yours. You got it all out of your system. You're the one that needed to talk about it.
Hey, I'm just throwing it out there. I'm just saying that's craziness. You know what I did find out, though?
What?
I did find out that in Reidsville, there is a gay ranch.
What?
Reidsville is the next town over.
Wait, what's a gay? Is that for, like, animals that are gay?
It must be. I don't understand the concept.
Maybe Clarence should go over there, huh?
Dude, Clarence is gay. So that...
He won't touch the female goats.
Well, they won't let him. They're not mature enough. And I think he's realized that. But he's calmed down a little bit since we got him out there. So it seems to be working. It seems to be working all right. But when it is time to get rid of Clarence, I am going to take him over to the gay ranch in Reidsville. Be like, y'all would love this goat.
What in the world is a gay? Like, is it called the gay ranch, or is it just what the locals call it? And what is the real? What's the? You don't know. Well, I need to know what the real name of this is because it's got to be something really funny.
I don't know what the real name is.
Oh come on! You know what the real name is.
I don't know what the real name is. It's a gathering place for homosexuals in Reidsville. And it's on a ranch, so that way there's a little bit of privacy set off to the side.
What?
I was very shocked when I found out about it because...
When did you find out about this?
Maybe 2 or 3 months ago. I was like, that doesn't seem right to me. Seems out of place. But whatever.
Is it where... So what you're telling me, this gay ranch that... Well, it's called the Rainbow Ranch. That's a good. That's a good name for it. So
call it whatever.
The
you
Rainbow
want.
Ranch is where homosexual people go to corral and farm gay animals. Right.
Yes. Yes.
Are they corralling gay animals over there?
No. What do you mean by?
I'm just using like farming names.
Farm names?
Yeah, like what are they?
I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know.
I don't know.
Does everybody have to be like, do they have any straight animals there?
Well, I mean, it'd be sexist if they didn't, right?
It's the Rainbow Ranch, dude. Like,
well, would a straight animal be welcome at the Rainbow Ranch?
That's a good question.
I don't see why not. I think that they got to be, you got to let everybody, you know, participate.
Do you?
And live on the ranch and everything. I don't know. I don't know what the rules are. I mean, I'm sure it's private property. So
do you have to pay your
private property?
Do you have to pay dues?
Oh, yeah. They're $67.95 a month. I don't know if you have to pay dues.
Dude, it sounds like a really exclusive club.
Oh, yeah. It's quite exclusive.
Yeah.
There's application and everything. You got to get references. I mean, there's a whole, it's a whole to-do.
All right. So,
it's a whole big thing.
They call up your reference. Hey, Martin, so how gay is your friend Jerry? Oh, man, that guy is so gay. It's like written all over his face, you know? Like, yeah. Literally, he should just put a Sharpie on his forehead and says, I'm gay. That's how gay he is. Oh,
right.
Well, perfect. He'll fit right in at this gay ranch. Rainbow Ranch, home of the gays.
Well, I would think that they would also ask, you know, what his ranching background is, because you don't want a bunch of amateurs in there who are incapable or inexperienced taking care of animals.
Yeah, but that...
you got to take care of the animals, too. That's an important part of the ranch.
I'm going to be totally honest with you. I don't think what you and I are thinking goes on at this ranch is what actually goes on at this ranch.
Well, let me tell you the sort of things that happen at my farm up here.
Okay.
We have a mess of critters that live in the backyard. And when it's time to take care of them, what we like to do is we like to go out to the backyard. Okay. And we like to feed them.
Okay.
Change out their water. We like to pick up a critter and pet them. We like to pet the goats, give them a treat, you know? And I give them an apple, maybe some carrots. They like that. Check on the chickens.
Do you ever milk
the
goats?
The ducks. No, we haven't milked these goats at all. The girls are too young, and the guys, that's not milk. So... yeah, that's right. Think about it.
Okay,
think
all
about
right,
what
all right,
we
continue.
Talked about
what
before.
Else do you do on
you
your
think about it.
On your farm?
You think
I'm not
about
thinking
it.
About it. I'm not thinking about
think
it.
About it.
Refuse to.
You can never recover. We just go out there and we look for eggs.
Okay. So what you're telling me is you think what goes on in your farm is the same thing that goes over at the Rainbow Ranch.
Right. I think they probably
except
have
they probably do it wearing chaps and nothing else, right?
Well, I don't know about that. That's a little stereotypical, isn't it? I mean, do you know any... Listen, I know some homosexual folks, and none of them wore chaps without pants. I mean, that wasn't like a real thing. None of them owned a mesh shirt, as far as I could tell. I mean, all that stuff is just, that's just TV stuff. That's not real.
Know what? I totally agree with you on this. However, how many gay guys have you seen at a gay ranch?
You got a good point there. I've not been to the gay ranch.
Which I'm proud of you for not going to that. Thank you for...
But the very concept just is... The very concept of it surprised me a lot.
Yeah.
Because that doesn't seem like that would be the kind of thing that would work around here.
You're correct. I agree. It sounds like something. I don't think it would work where I'm at either. No, it would not. It would definitely not. That would definitely not work down here. You'd have to go to like Orlando, and there ain't no ranches over there.
So it's a property value issue.
No,
you can't get enough land. I mean, it's too expensive.
Dude, I don't think... Listen, I really don't think...
I understand. More expensive to live in Orlando than it is to live in
That's not what I'm saying. That's not what I'm saying. Just don't think that... I think we're kind of off in what we think happens at a gay ranch. I don't think it's what we think it is.
You just take care of the animals. That's all ranches are. You take care of the animals, you raise them.
Well, yeah. But...
You collect the eggs...
But I kind of feel like it might be something else, Martin.
Yeah. It's sort of like, a club kind of thing. You know, for folks who happen to be gay, but also want to engage in ranching activity.
Are you sure about this? Like...
Yeah, I don't think it's as exclusive as all that. And I imagine that if a a heterosexual person wanted to join the gay ranch, that would probably be okay, because you don't want one of those Supreme Court cake baking things going on. You know what I'm saying? You don't want one of those happening. Nobody wants that.
Martin,
so they're just gonna go with it.
I don't think this has.
Gonna be like, all right, come in and feed the chickens, and you can board your horse here. You know, that kind of stuff.
Why would it be
horse boarding is probably
you the think that's what you think that's guess. What's going on there is they're boarding their animals there.
That makes sense to me. Look, if you live in town, you probably don't have enough space Martin. For a horse or all the chickens you want to keep or the pigs or the donkeys or the goats or sheep or whatever kind of.
I love you, but you're so naive, Martin.
But you gotta
abort. No, Martin, I love you, but you're.
They gotta live somewhere.
Yeah, I'm sure they do.
They can't just live in town. Maybe a chicken can live.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, dude, you live in Georgia. Anything can live in a town. Like your towns. Listen, your towns are not like towns in normal places. You know.
This is a very normal place. All right, it's very normal.
A normal place with a gay farm.
Well, I mean, it's a ranch, for one.
Gay ranch. I apologize.
It's in Reedsville, not Glenville. So, and there's a big difference between Reedsville and Glenville.
Okay. So,
it's a big difference.
I'm struggling with this so bad because I just feel
we don't think much of people from Reedsville.
Obviously, because they have a gay ranch.
It's not about that. It's because they live in the other town. They're our rivals.
Oh, so, okay. All right.
At least they used to be. And then they combined the high schools into one county high school.
Wow.
Very dramatic.
So you think that a gay ranch is just a ranch? Like, it's called the gay ranch by everybody else.
Yeah.
And you think it's just a place where gay people go to, just to do ranching stuff.
To board their animals.
To ride their gay horses and then ride gay bulls, perhaps?
I don't think that the animals have to be gay.
Are you sure? Well, you said that earlier. I feel like you're backpedaling, Martin. You're backpedaling.
I might backpedal a little bit. Like, I'm thinking that the homosexual community is a very tight-knit community, right? I mean, this is something that's legit. The homosexual community is very, very tight-knit, very close together, you know, take care of each other, all that kind of stuff, right? So if some of them wanted to make sure that there was opportunity to board a farm animal, you know, that it was there, that it was available.
Oh my gosh.
Within the community, right? Within this very specific subculture of rural homosexuals that live in town that don't have space.
What's the word for
bonus material?
This is gonna have to be bonus material, man. We're gonna talk about something else. I'm gonna have to cut this and put this somewhere else. Martin.
I'm just saying that I found out about this rant and it surprised me and I thought it was weird.
Why is it?
It just seems out of place
for your town.
It's a traditional sort of area.
Oh, I agree with you. It is definitely a traditional sort of area. I'm gonna burst your bubble.
I mean, we just got MySpace here. It's pretty awesome.
Oh my gosh.
We really like it. This dude Tom's my friend. It's pretty sweet.
Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. He's
top 8. Top 8, brother.
Top 8. Oh my gosh.
Top 8. You're in my top 8 too, friend.
I am? I have MySpace?
Absolutely. Absolutely. You're ranked even higher than Tom.
Really?
Sure, why not?
Wow, man, thanks. I appreciate that.
Like a champion.
I think that
for the podcast, we should get rid of this Facebook stuff and Twitter and all that and just isolate to MySpace. We should move everything over to there.
Okay.
And say if you wanna interact with us, we only do it through MySpace. That's our communications portal.
Oh gosh, this is going so horrible. This is going.
This is not what you expected. This was not the plan.
No, I think we're leading all of our listeners astray, all three of them. Okay.
Right, because what we really want to talk about. Look, the whole Kavanaugh thing. of, you know, this Supreme Court justice, very hotly contested, being placed on the Supreme Court. We're not talking about that, right? This big fight between McGregor and Khabib? No, we're not talking about that, right? No, we're going to talk about gay ranches and... And you, why they exist in the,
you genuinely
in the rural homosexual
You genuinely
community.
Think that it's the gay ranch is for, like, you know, agriculturalists that are gay go. Or it's like gay horticulturalists.
Think,
That's
I
what
think,
you think.
I think that we stereotype the homosexual community into just a bunch of sex-crazed individuals, and I just don't think that hasn't borne out.
Okay, okay.
With the gay people that I've met and known, and
I don't.
Met,
I, here's the deal:
life.
Why can't a gay person just go to a regular
have a goat,
go?
Right?
Well, no, go to a regular farm to board their goat, gay or not.
Well, they could. They could.
Then why do they need a gay farm?
Because it's a very tight-knit community.
No,
so
no, this
them,
is that.
It's a tight-knit community.
Stop saying that.
Why is that so
stop.
Bad to say?
Listen, Martin, I'm going to burst your bubble. I'm going to burst your bubble. It's not for agriculture, horticulturalists, and gays like that. It's
That's got to be a part of
no.
it. Everybody here is into agriculture in some way or another.
No, they're definitely not.
Doesn't matter
they're not
who
plowing
you are.
The fields at that farm.
Hey.
I'm going to say, they're not plowing the fields at that farm, Martin.
Black or white?
No.
Male or female?
No. Martin...
Right.
It's
if you live up here, you're into agriculture.
It's a gay dating community.
Gay or straight.
It's a gay dating community is what it is. And that's putting it nice.
No.
Yeah, yeah. You have
it. It can't just be that. There's gotta be something else.
Well, they're probably
something
all
more.
Cowboys and stuff like that or ranchers in some way.
Yeah.
It's kinda like
we have ranchers, not cowboys.
What's that? Farmersonly.com? It's like that. Except it's gayfarmersonly.com in Reedsville.
So it's a cross between Grindr and Farmers Only?
Yeah, pretty much.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I had not considered that.
You seriously didn't consider that because I really feel like you're lying right now. You know that's what it is. You're just trying to pretend. You're trying to...
Listen. I don't know what it is, okay, because I've not been there. I've only heard about its existence... And it's just intriguing to me because I'm surprised by
it. But what if people...
There's also...
Go ahead.
There's also up here, you're not even going to believe this, up here there is a terrorist training camp on the other side of the river. Right? So it's down on the Jessup side of the river.
Listen.
There's a terrorist training
camp. Listen, don't let the terrorist training camp know where the gay farm is, okay? That's a bad...
Oh yeah, that's got to go bad.
That'll go bad.
It's not going to be good. And the funny thing about the terrorist training camp is that everybody knows about it. Everybody knows that there's a terrorist training camp on the other side of the river down towards Jessup. We all know.
Have you seen it?
No, you can't see it.
And so you haven't seen this. You haven't seen the gay ranch. I feel like it's a bunch of rumors, Martin. It sounds like gossip to me.
Nah, this is all legit.
Listen,
this is
you know
all
what it
real.
Is? The gay ranch.
Real.
Somebody.
It's for real.
Somebody went
real.
Over to this ranch. To get a goat, the guy, the farmer that was there came out. He was a little bit more feminine than most farmers. And they're like, oh, this has got to be a gay ranch.
Just chaps, no pants.
Yeah, he shows up in chaps,
mesh
no
shirt.
Pants with a mesh shirt. And like, oh, man, this is a gay ranch. No, the guy just, that's how he's comfortable. He likes mesh shirts. He doesn't like to wear pants, but he loves chaps, you know. Let's just say it that way. That's what it was.
If you're gonna do ranching activities, you need to wear some jeans.
Yeah.
And you need to wear a shirt, probably with long sleeves, like a long sleeve button up shirt. That's what most of the guys up here who are farming are wearing.
Yeah, but I'm just gonna say it this way.
You gotta keep
it
the sun
all hot. Gets all hot in the afternoon there. You've got ripped abs. You're gonna want to take that shirt off and just show it off, right? Right.
Yeah. You gotta take a cold can of Pepsi and put it on the back of your neck.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Cool you right off.
Absolutely.
Nah. Terrorist training camp, gay ranch, all this stuff is happening.
You think the gay ranch
totally
and the you
down.
Think the gay ranch and the terrorist training camp have anything in common?
Just the fact that up here, we really believe in people's individual rights to practice liberty and however they want, whether it's training for terrorist attacks or participating in homosexual agriculture.
It's not homosexual agriculture. It's homosexual acts. It's not agriculture. They're not a bunch of homosexual horticulturalists. Martin, no. Oh my gosh. This is horrible.
Homosexual horticulturalists.
That's so good. It's a good one. It's a really good one. It's because they got a... You get it? Because they got a green thumb. Oh, God.
Oh, man. I'm just saying those places are here. They're here.
Yeah, I guess so.
And we know about them, and, you know, it's whatever. It's whatever. You want to train in some paramilitary kind of stuff, you know, in service to Allah or whatever, you know, do you.
You can go to Georgia.
Do your thing.
Hey, that can be like some of Georgia's, like, new things. Like, hey, you want to come and, you know, Georgia, like, when you say, you know... What is the peach? Is that the
peach state?
Yeah, the peach state. You're like, hey, we're the peach state where you can come and you can practice to be a terrorist or raise your gay goats on our gay farms.
Right. Yeah.
Man, they're
why not?
You know, they're a little more progressive than I thought they would be.
They are, aren't they?
You're Georgia. Yeah.
I wasn't expecting either of those things to be tolerated.
No, like, really. Honestly, if I feel like if we knew there was a terrorist training camp in Osceola County,
mm-hmm. that the rednecks would go and take care of it.
All the rednecks would go over there and take care of it. I genuinely think...
That's what I thought.
Yeah. But now your rednecks are all like, nah, man. They can do whatever they want.
They're like, they don't bother me. River. Well, that is the mentality, because when I heard guys talking about that, I was like, how have you guys not gone over there and just torn it up? They're like,
why would we do that?
Well, that's not our property. Why would we mess with those guys?
We're not. Why? Do what they're all want. Like, why would we do such a thing?
Why?
Like, they're freaking terrorists.
Doesn't matter. Don't care.
Yeah. Wait. Wait a second. What about this gay? What about this gay farm? What about this gay ranch? Like, wouldn't you guys? Aren't you guys like upset about that? They're like, hey, man, it ain't our ranch.
Got nothing to, got do, nothing with my, to do with my goat.
Isn't this the Bible Belt? Well, you know.
Yeah.
We're kind of.
Well, I mean, lower. Once upon a time.
Yeah, a little lower on the belt. And, you know.
You want,
it's like the bottom part of the Bible Belt.
It's like. It's like the crotchless part of the chest.
Yeah. So that's about where. It's where the belt is pretty big. We're like the bottom part
the
of the belt.
A little higher. Yeah. We're kind of lower.
Yeah. We're lower. Yeah.
It's 61% of the population in Tattnall County self-identifies as non-religious.
Hmm.
Right? So we're not even talking about nominal Christianity. The majority of the people in Tattnall County self-identify as non-religious. So when you get that statistic and you really start to understand it, then terrorist training camps in another county
gay ranch
nearby
makes sense.
And gay ranches are not super surprising anymore.
I'm still surprised, even though.
And the toleration of those things.
I'll be honest with you. If we had a gay ranch around here, I'm pretty sure because we got a lot of churches too. I'm pretty sure every church would be in an uproar. You know, like going and just protesting and things like that. I really genuinely think that's what would happen.
You would have protesters? Because that accomplishes a lot.
Oh, I know that. I agree. I mean, I'm not going to do it. I don't want to.
You're not gonna lead Northeast Christian Church out there with a bunch of signs.
How dare they raise these gay cows in their gay ways? We've got to show them the way. I'd been like, you know what? I'm gonna go over here and
I'm gonna go do my thing somewhere.
I'm gonna do something.
I'm not gonna mess with that.
Yeah, you can.
Well,
be gay in your gay ranch you want. I don't particularly care. But like I genuinely think there would be a pretty big uproar in Osceola County if there was gay ranch.
You really think
oh,
so?
Oh yeah.
I don't think I don't think anybody would care.
No, I think there would. I think, like a nudist colony. Yeah, like, we got a nudist colony, you know, and that's pretty well accepted by everybody. But if it was a gay,
just appreciation of the human
form. Yeah, but if it was a gay nudist colony, I really genuinely think people would freak out. I'm not saying they should.
Why don't you start one then let me know?
No, not gonna do it, buddy. Not gonna do it.
I know a trap when I hear one.
It's a trap.
This whole conversation has been a trap. Yeah. Hey. Oh, I can't show it to you because the connection's poor at the moment.
I can see it.
You see that?
It's a cookie.
That's a cookie. Now, this is a cookie that Leia made, and she is perfecting cookies. And this is made with one of our homegrown eggs.
Oh, yeah?
Straight out of Henrietta's body.
Oh. Right out of Henrietta's butt. And into your out of Henrietta's butt and into your mouth.
Let me tell you, Leia knows how to make a chocolate chip cookie. She is like a chocolate chip cookie artist. All right.
Slow down. Listen. Slow down. And describe. Chew it slower and describe what you're tasting right now to me, because I have not had a chocolate chip cookie in probably 6 months.
All right. Well, let me tell you about this.
Slow.
For starters. The bottom has a little bit of crisp.
Oh, my gosh.
All right. So the bottom's a little bit crisp. The top
is nice and chewy. Okay. I don't know if I can take any more.
It's got a hint of butter.
Martin, I said I can't take any more.
And the bite into it was really pleasant.
Oh, my gosh.
Because the top is the chewiness, and the bottom's got a little bit of crispness. It's just the right amount of sweetness, not too sweet. Just the right amount of sweetness. She's really turning cookie making into an art form.
Martin, I haven't.
I gotta tell you, these things are delicious.
I have not had a cookie in forever.
It
is my choice, but. Like, I have not had, I kind of want to go to Walmart right now and buy one of those chewy, Chips Ahoy thing. I love those chewy ones. And, just eat it by the stack. They all come out, you got to pull them apart. You know, they're all chewy, they're, really soft.
I know what you're talking about.
And you can, pull them out by the stack. I just want to eat it, as a sandwich.
But do you want the results of having eaten that?
No, because I probably won't have an ab anymore. And I'm kind of getting close to a second, row of abs. I'm getting relatively close. And I don't...
It's so good, Justin.
Oh, gosh. I'm getting lightheaded just watching you eat that.
So nice. Right.
You gotta stop this. You gotta stop, Martin!
That's my snack.
Get behind me, Satan!
There's nothing evil about this.
My mouth is watering right now.
Oh, my goodness. It's so good.
It's the devil.
It's so good.
It's the devil.
Hey, check out this. I'm going to save this one.
Oh, you got another one? You piece of... Oh, my gosh.
So good. So nice. We have the dough. There we go.
Stop it.
We have the cookie dough in the fridge.
Oh, my gosh.
And I just baked these a little while ago, right before we started recording.
Oh, my gosh.
Took them out of the oven.
Ugh.
So good. Oh,
you
so
do
nice.
This on purpose, aren't you?
Yes, I'm deliberately eating these cookies because I love them.
In front of me.
Leia doesn't make them nearly often enough. I want them every day. But, you know, she's a little more conscious about calorie intake, and she knows that if she makes them, I'm going to eat them all because they're so good, and I lack personal discipline. But... it's worthwhile.
Oh, gosh.
Totally worth it. I don't care if I don't have abs. You can keep your ab and your second row of an ab. You can have that. I'm going to eat these cookies.
Yeah, whatever.
Because you can only have two abs that are showing on the top, but I can have three cookies tonight. So you should consider that as a part of... What is the point? What is the point of living longer if you're miserable while you do it, not enjoying the wonderful gifts that God has given to us, like a perfectly made cookie.
Okay, okay. I will go on the record to say that I was fine until I saw you start to make love to that cookie, okay? I was fine up until that point.
There's a lot of love going on really, with these cookies.
Yeah, you really, I mean, granted, I did ask you, you to describe it. I did, and slowly. But you seductively ate that cookie, and yes, up until that point, I was fine. Like, seriously, I even,
everything
I even
was
said,
okay.
I said something to somebody earlier. I said, dude, I'm perfectly fine with not eating carbs or sugar. I'm perfectly fine with it, because I am, up until that point, and now I want to go buy the Chewy Chips Ahoy and eat it by the sleeve.
What you need is one of these cookies that Leia made. You cannot cheat on your diet with something that's trashy.
You know what would be good?
Cheat with something really good.
You know what would be good? It's like...
Red velvet cake.
What? Red velvet in that little boy's smile. Isn't that the song?
Yes, that is.
That's what I thought.
It's about cake.
About cake.
Give me that cake.
Yeah. You know, you remember those like... I haven't had these in like probably... 5 years, but like Fig Newtons.
Yeah.
Man, I could eat those.
My kids we get them all the time.
I eat those. I could eat those like a wood chipper. You know, I just like take the whole stack and just shove it into my mouth and just.
Do you on a Fig Newton, do you eat the. Excuse me. Oh, my. Oh. Excuse me.
You almost burped up your heart, I saw.
Yeah, I did. I almost died. I had a mini
heart attack.
You're like,
what's the point of, you know, living longer if you're going to be miserable? Oh, I'm dying! Damn cookie!
Well, you know, if I have to die, and I do, I'd rather die eating one of these cookies if I have my choice.
Hey, listen, if I start to die right now, I'm going to be like, someone get me a cookie!
This isn't worth it.
I'm going to eat this cookie as I die. I am. I'm going to eat the cookie while I die.
But when you eat a Fig Newton, I always eat the edges first. Right? The little piece of cake. So that way, it all looks like I can, all the way around it, I can see cake, fig, cake. Right? I can see that all the way around it. That's how I eat a Fig Newton.
Really?
So I nibble around the outside to get it all like that. And then I eat the rest of it. Very systematic in a Fig Newton.
I think you're putting way too much thought into eating your Fig Newtons. Like I said, I eat it like it's a wood chipper. Like I take the whole sleeve, start shoving it into my mouth. Yeah.
You don't get to eat Fig Newtons, though, when you're doing...
No, but I just started thinking about it right now because you ate that cookie in front of me. So, yeah. I'll eat a Fig Newton again.
I'm sort of like the devil on your shoulder.
Yeah, you're not.
Eat the shirt.
You're not like the devil on my shirt. You are the devil on my shoulder.
Okay.
You are the stumbling block to my walk.
Good.
Okay.
Good. Your walk. Do you really want to compare and utilize Christian language to talk about you being on a diet?
Yeah.
Come on, brother.
Yeah,
no,
I would.
It's not good enough.
It's just as much discipline.
Up your game.
It's just as much discipline.
No, that's a personal... It is not as much discipline. That is a personal problem that you're dealing with. You need to get things
spiritually. I'm spiritually dealing
get
with
it.
It
all together.
It's a spiritual thing.
It's a spiritual battle.
It is a spiritual battle.
What is the spiritual battle that you're facing there, buddy?
It's not...
The cookie battle?
The spiritual cookie battle.
The spiritual cookie battle?
Yeah.
Yes. That is the
Doesn't
one.
It sound about right?
Yeah. No.
You're not going to deny whatever. This. You're not going to deny me this.
I don't know. I would think that your struggles against sinfulness would be greater than your struggle against sugariness. But, you know, every person is...
Well, I
kind of
feel like,
right?
You know, a little overindulgence in areas is just as sinful. Like, you can overindulge in food, Martin. And I just so happen to do that.
Okay. Do you think that overindulgence in food is just as evil as, say, I don't know, going out to a gay ranch and banging a bunch of dudes?
Well, I'm not the person that's going to say one sin's, you know, worse than another sin and things like that. Because then we're, you know.
I will. It's pretty clear in the Bible. I don't mind saying that. Yeah.
Yeah. No. Well, listen, I don't have.
Gluttony is not as severe as adultery.
Here's the deal. I don't have the problem with going to a gay ranch, but I do have the problem. I do have the problem with eating a giant pile of pasta until I can't breathe anymore. And
dude, you did it until you couldn't breathe anymore?
Dude, of course. I'm getting like a giant, you know, New York style pizza. I love how you say pizza.
That. You're like, obviously, dude, why wouldn't I? Why wouldn't I?
I'd eat like, you know, half of it, you know, easily. Half of this giant extra large from Antonio's, which used to be La Bella Napolis.
Oh, yeah.
Same place. It's the same place, different name. Great pizza, all right? And then, like...
Dude, I can't eat a half of one of those. Those are those big pizzas, too.
I know, man. I would put away half of that pizza. I'd have, like, two of the giant garlic knots, all right? Then I have, you know, whatever else we could, you know, cram in there. You know, talking, like, you know, half a 2-liter of soda. Dude, that's a lot of food. That's overindulgence.
It is a lot of food.
And so, like, I don't have the problem with going to a gay ranch, Martin, but I do have the problem with eating way too much till it makes me sick and it actually affects my health.
All right.
So, spiritual problem.
Really, though?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
All right.
How would you like to participate in the Two Bearded Preachers podcast? Well, let me tell you how you can do that. One, you can go ahead and send us an email at twobeardedpreachers@gmail.com, or you can go ahead and give us a call at 951-47-BEARD. That's 951-472-3273. Leave a message, and if you do that, we'll actually play your voice, your message, on the podcast. And don't forget to go ahead and give us a 5-star rating on your favorite podcast platform. That will really help the show grow, and we would appreciate it greatly. Thanks so much. See you next week.
If you live out on the farm, you can grow all the weed you want, or all the crack rocks.
Yeah, I don't think you. I think you need to mine. I think you need to mine for crack rock.
You mine crack rocks, right? I just found the vein.
Found a vein of crack rock here, right next to this ore of gold. Hey,
that's right.
You got your you got suspenders on and a pickaxe
and a.
And then you're at the. You got your little pan and everything like that, and you're in your pond, and you're like. You're getting in the dirt, you're paying for crack rock. Oh, I think I got one right here. Oh, let me see it. Oh, that's fool's crack. Oh, no.
Fool's crack.
That's horrible.
Fool's crack just doesn't get you high.
Or fool's crack doesn't get you near as high as real crack. It's like a fake high. Like, you're kind of thinking, you're like, am I tripping or not? I don't know. Maybe you're like, feel high.
Should we know more about this? Like, should we be more educated on how these drugs work?
I don't know.